Learning program at BCC to thank a man who has done an amazing job in the past 17 years, and that's our president, Jack Springer. Thank you.
What they mean is environment, and I thank you for having provided that for our students. And I thank our students for all you've done, and you'll continue to carry that torch wherever you go. Wherever you go, you'll take BCC with you. So thank you very much. Please enjoy the day, and it's going to be a wonderful celebration.
Civic engagement, and our keynote speaker today is somebody who demonstrates that in the ocean work, and he also demonstrates it with what he does in the community that he does on his own, not at all. Jeffrey Pelletier serves as the president of Junior Achievement of Southern Massachusetts. JA is the nation's largest organization dedicated to young people the knowledge and skills they need to own their future, focusing on the critically important content areas of career readiness, financial literacy, and entrepreneurship. JA of Southern Massachusetts, headquartered in the city of New Bedford, reaches nearly 6,000 students each year across 21 cities and towns. Previously, Pelletier supported the Strategic Economic Development Agenda of the city of New Bedford as the Business Development and Communications Officer for the New Bedford Economic Development Council. He also served as Program Director for Executives Without Borders, a nonprofit organization dedicated to engaging the business community and solving the world's greatest humanitarian challenges. In Haiti, he directed a nationwide jobs and recycling program that collected over 35 million plastic bottles and generated over 250,000 in incomes for communities in need. In Honduras, he directed private sector engagement projects with a Fortune 500 company to increase the sustainability of the life-saving medical work of the nonprofit organization Central American Medical Outreach. He's a graduate of Methodist University in North Carolina with a degree in business administration. He's also a graduate of Bishop Tang High School and of the Leadership South Coast program. He volunteers as a member of the board for Leadership South Coast, the New Bedford Education Foundation, and Missions for Humanity. He's a member of the New Bedford Economic Development Council, and he volunteers for the Ron Burton Training Village each summer. He was nominated for the 2014 and 2015 South Coast Emerging Leader Award. Please join me in welcoming our keynote speaker, Jeffrey Pelletier.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
You'll have to excuse my voice a little bit here this morning. We have a two-year-old who is becoming quite proficient in bringing home a variety of things home from daycare. And so we just have to push forward. But it's a great honor to be here this morning. We're really grateful to Aaron and everyone at BCC for having me here, just for all that you do in the extremely important areas. What you do in the community through your civic engagement and co-op program. And I just had a few thoughts to share this morning. With what we do at Junior Achievement, what's neat is we're in the classroom, right? We're with our local students every day. And so just inherently, we're talking about the future for them. We're talking about what our future workforce is going to look like, how our community is going to look in the future, what our future opportunities are, and also our challenges. And so when I think about the work that all the students here do and what this program does, particularly starting on the challenge front, I think it's critically important. And I was just looking over at our table, seeing the student work you've done that from everywhere from the FDA to the Butler Park Zoo. Because the reality, if we think about some of our future challenges, it's going to take all of us to solve them. Right? We kind of start at a place of we're all in this together, right? Across so many areas, whether we look at environmental challenges or economic challenges or social challenges, we are all in this together. And so in my own life, when I did work in Haiti and Honduras, it was because in a very visceral way, I just had this notion of If this little girl in Port-au-Prince gets an education, that's good for me. That's good for my family. Right? Cancer runs my family. Maybe she's the one who becomes a doctor with the breakthrough cure. When I think about the work that you all do through your service learning and civic engagement programs, that's why we want the little boy in Fall River to get an education, because we don't know what he will be. We don't know if he's going to be the one who creates the next technological breakthrough that fundamentally moves things forward. Right? We don't know, but all that we do know is that when we invest in each other, only good things are going to happen. And so in my life, the work that I've done overseas, and now the work that I do here, that's the approach in the model that I took. Is this notion of investing in each other, knowing that to solve some of these challenges that are coming down the pike and that are already upon us now, it is going to take all of us. And so the work, for the students, and then again, to talking at NJ right now, we work with BCC with partners, and so I know some of the work that you all do, and it's just incredibly important. We have a range of issues facing us locally now, and it's an all hands on deck situation. And so I think it's incredibly important the impact that the BCC students are driving in our community right now through this work. In thinking to the future as well, on the opportunity side, I think civic engagement and service learning, and I'm sure the students in the room now would agree to this, is I also think it can be a tremendous accelerator in your own life to find your passion and to do what you're meant to do. And I know that was the case for me, but when I went down to Honduras, and I was kind of kid about this, I went down as an intern volunteer. When I started my work in international development, and I kind of leaned forward on my ability to speak Spanish to get the gig. Maybe not to Spanish school, but I kind of leaned forward to get the gig, and I ended up meeting my wife actually on my first morning in Honduras. And so there's all kinds of benefits that you end up getting. She was my translator. She took good care of me there, still the same here today. But by really getting engaged in the community, and for me that was an internship in that particular period, you don't know where that's going to take you. And it really allows you to deliver so much value, and you make connections. And for me, I'm from here. I grew up in New Bedford, and I am able, amidst all the challenges of running a nonprofit organization, I'm able to at least say I'm doing what I want to be doing with my life. I am competing and working towards the things that I genuinely believe in, that I've always wanted my life to be about. And all of that started through that internship. In my own career, it progressed from there. And so I think it's just an incredibly important program here, that you do have both the community impact that BCC and all the students are driving and making impact in so many areas. And for each student, I would just encourage all of you to continue to find your passion, to use these different civic engagement experiences to see what fits and see what doesn't fit, to see what gets you out of bed in the morning, on fire. Don't need an alarm clock. You're doing what you think you're meant to do. And I would just say, lastly here, towards that notion, particularly to all the students in the room, because that's what this region requires. That's, I think, what our future challenges require. That's what this community requires. It is all of you to be utilizing all of the skills that you learned here at BCC, to utilize the connections that you made in your service learning projects, and to propel this community, this region, this country, and the world forward. It's just what we require, and I think through this program you've got a tremendous head start. So fan of everything that the BCC does across the community, and most certainly in this area. It's a thrill for me to be here today and learn more about all the good work that you're doing, and I really appreciate it. Thank you very much.
Involved in service learning for nearly her entire time here at the college and has continuously exceeded the expectations of her professor. This student has participated in projects such as clinical abstinence bone marrow drives, would be a match, a health and wellness fair designed to help students recognize the importance of self-care and encouraging students to take a break for themselves during finals, and most recently, a series of open educational resources that provide future classes with course content and study materials outside of the textbook. Students in clinical app science have tasked with a project to create these OERs for future students, and all students in the class are responsible for different content areas. Not only did this student complete her required content, she sought to infuse her love of art with the project and took it upon herself to hand draw over a dozen images that corresponded with the project and content in an effort to bring the content to life. In the last few semesters, she has been instrumental in the success of 8 different service learning projects. In addition to her service learning projects, this student has worked over the last year to serve her fellow students, taking on the roles of supplemental instructor, tutor, and orienting new freshmen. She continually goes above and beyond to assist other students with their studies and has taken an active interest in the success of struggling students, playing a key role in their academic progress. She truly exemplifies everything we hope for, not just of our service learning students, but all of our students here at BCC. So it is my honor to present Vanessa Lill with the Service Learning Student of the Year. So our Community Partner of the Year Award for 2016-2017 goes to the United Way of Greater Amherst Common, an agency whose mission is to improve lives by uniting the caring power of communities to advance the common good. The United Way of Greater Attleboro Common traditionally serves as an umbrella organization and funding source for many of our community partners in Attleboro and Common, and promoting our program and connecting us to these organizations. However, this year they themselves took on the role of being one of our community partners for a Marketing 101 service learning course in Attleboro. Students in this marketing course were assigned to a SWOT analysis of a nonprofit organization that would provide the organization with recommendations and strategies to achieve their mission, and they did this on fairly short notice. And the United Way helped us craft 2 projects for them. One was how to engage baby boomers post-retirement, because they have a strong population of baby boomers who have been heavily involved, both as volunteers and donors over the years. And then the second project was how to engage millennials to come in and take the reins of the retiring boomers. These projects allow the students to take the theoretical concepts from their course and apply them in a real way, enhancing their learning of not only the course content, but of work being done in and for their community. We are very grateful for the experience they have provided our students this year and look forward to a long and prosperous partnership in the years to come. So, Jamie, can you please come up and set their community partners?
Civic Engagement and the Cooperative Education Program, Experiential Learning, but with other programs as well. I have said many times, and I want to say this morning in closing, I think it's the greatest compliment that I can pay to Bristol Community College. It works exactly as it's intended to work for the benefit of the people who live in our region. Not all organizations can say that, and not all of them can do it to such an excellent standard is what happens here at BCC. And it happened because of people, happened because of Dr. Sprague, happened because of the many staff and faculty in that year. And it happens because we have students who come here for a reason to take advantage of what this college offers to improve their own lives. And once again, it's a wonderful opportunity for us to come and break bread, to enjoy the success of individuals and of an institution in our region. We've come to the end. Thank you for coming. Thank you for being someone who cares about Bristol Community College. Please drive safely and enjoy the rest of your day.